Hey Speechies, it's Sarah, and I'm back today to give you five ways that you can tackle stuttering in your speech therapy. Now, I'm going to talk a little bit about techniques you can use with younger kids, and then also techniques you can use with older students. Number one, if you are working with little guys who stutter, I would first start out with thinking time. And I use a visual cue for that too. I would go, let's use our thinking time before we answer this question. That kind of thing. And you don't even have to say, you can just go. And that gives your brain a chance to come up with what it wants to tell your mouth to say. So thinking time is great, and it is something that I also do use with older students too, but I wouldn't phrase it in the same way. I would tell students to not feel rushed when they're ready to respond to a question, to not put pressure on themselves to come up with something really quickly, and take their time when they're answering a question. Number two, taking turns. Taking turns is a technique that I use in therapy with students of all ages. And if I have a student that stutters and they're in a group, I will definitely make a point of having everybody take turns. And that is something I also advise parents when I'm talking to them about how to make communication at home a little easier for everybody. And that is to really let everybody have a turn to talk so that there's no pressure for somebody to try to jump in and add a comment. Number three, eye contact. Eye contact is really valuable to teach people who stutter because oftentimes when they feel a moment of stuttering coming, they look away or down. And that does not help that forward flow of speech, but making eye contact does. Number four, easy onsets. Easy onsets are really useful and they're best for those older elementary age or middle school students, but I also introduce it with younger students too, just to tell them, start an utterance in a way that's kind of very low tension, stretching out that vowel and just kind of gliding right into an utterance or sentence or word. And it does take a lot of practice to get that technique down well. And that's part of why I think it is good to start young with that, with students, just to get them to realize that when they put pressure on themselves, it adds like physiological tension in their vocal folds. And so what we want to do is to make that tension go away because that is how we perpetuate stuttering with all the tension. So we definitely want to have them stretch out those words and not feel either time pressure or that pressure to talk quickly. Number five, counseling. Counseling is really important for students who stutter and their families. When you've got a littler student, you can't necessarily tackle those feelings, but you can talk to families and say, look, there's nothing wrong about stuttering. Developmental stuttering can actually spontaneously recover. And so part of how you facilitate that, you're trying to facilitate an environment that helps students feel confident and less stressed and less tension. So that is something you would counsel parents. As students get older, the students that don't recover from stuttering, the developmental stuttering, and they move into more persistent stuttering, that's time to talk about those feelings and your attitude towards stuttering. Because if you feel bad about yourself, or if you're taking this on in a way that it hurts your heart, that is going to make it harder for you to get control and be confident when you're communicating. Educating them about the speech machine. I'm sure you've seen those kind of things where you talk to them about how you produce speech and what's going on so that they can feel like it's not just a mystery. So those are my tips for stuttering. Just kind of a quick crash course video on what I like to do with my students who stutter as a starting point for therapy with them. And I will see you in the next video. Have a great day.